Hello and welcome to a FIFA 16 kind of update thing. So yeah, I'm just gonna tell you what's going on across the average thing. I will bring you career mode and ultimate team stuff in the future, so don't you worry about that. Probably be in the next couple of days as well. So yeah, FIFA 15 career mode, I will be still doing it. Won't be so as much because I've gone off FIFA because it like season's over and it seems it's just always a dry period, but I'll still be bringing Newcastle career mode stuff to you. So yeah, it says here FIFA 16 innovates across the entire pitch to deliver a balanced, authentic and exciting football experience that lets you play your way and compete at a high level. You'll have confidence in defending, head controlling midfield, and you'll produce more moments of magic than ever before. FIFA 16, play beautiful. That's like the kind of catchphrase. So yeah, I'll let you watch this first. This little clip.
The wait is finally over. The world's most captivating sport returns for another year of drama, intrigue, beauty, and suspense. Football is back.
At last.
Astonishing! Sublime finish! What a magnificent goal! Kagawa! Kane! Griezmann! Oh my word! What a goal! That is why they call it the beautiful game!
So yeah, that was FIFA. Confidence in defending. FIFA 16 gives you the tools to stop your opponent with confidence. Move with greater freedom as a defender, line your team to defend as a unit and your back line to track missing runs to create balance between attacking and defending. I don't know if this might be on the next part. Yeah, so basically what happens, this is the part I'm about to read. Defensive agility, use 25 innovative feat changes to mobility and locomotion to track skilled players. Mobile defenders can close down space and change for direction quickly using swing step behaviour to stay with your opponent. You'll feel freedom of movement as you track runs and look to break up attacks. This basically means when you step in for a challenge and a player went past you, your player won't just stand still for a bit and just just run back slowly. He'll actually when turn sharply and carry on running after the player. And stuff like that, as you can see there. Defend as a unit. Defend together, win together. Rely on your teammates to cover gaps when you close down an attacker. New defensive AI gives players better awareness of dangerous place on the pitch relative to the ball and their opponent. Your teammates will track back to stop sophisticated attacking runs and close down angles of attack. Now, basically, mean if you go in for attack, the defense will cover it, and when you move over right, as you should in real life, as I've learned. Your whole team should move right, same for left, and same if you're going up and down. New tackling fundamentals. Get stuck in and win back the ball with new tackling mechanics and animations. All new slide, standing and fake tackles make going in for the ball responsive, rewarding and fun. So basically, they've spent a lot of time working on defence with stuff such as what Kashani's doing there going to be in the game, I think. And the whole body shape and stuff, they've added that. It's just incredible what they've done. Controlling midfield. Games are won and lost in midfield. In FIFA 16, the midfield matters. Stay in possession with patient build-up play or ping clinical passes through space to start an attack. So yeah, they haven't really done that much in midfield, but it's still great. Interception intelligence. Players anticipate passes and move to shut down options and close passing channels. Smarter teammates will look for space and allow more opportunities to build play through the midfield. So yeah, some of this is kind of confusing, but you will get it as you go through FIFA and stuff like that. Passing with purpose. A revolution is pass in passing. FIFA 16 lets you play sharp, incisive passes so you can find teammates with precision. Using a new mechanic, ping-driven ground passes to find teammates in tight spaces to open your attacking options. So, like, you know, you, like, ping it across the floor and it just goes straight through, like, gaps in the defence and stuff like that. Creating more wow moments of magic. In FIFA 16, players will have a cutting edge. Every team needs to create moments of magic and unlock defences. So, yeah, that'll mean, like, stuff that they can do that can go past and stuff like that. Yeah, you do understand it, I'm sure, because you're all watching this for a reason, probably. No touch dribbling. The best touch can be the one you don't take. Free yourself from the ball to buy time, create separation, feint, and blow your defender just as Messi does when he is at his best. It's near limitless creativity on the ball. This is Messi's, like, own kind of skill. It's not really a skill, it's just something that can fool defenders and stuff like that. So, yeah, dynamic crossing. Send that cross in. Authentic crosses that you find teammates with greater accuracy. Attacking players run to and attack the ball with intent, making defences scramble as crosses are played behind the back line with vicious intent. So, yeah, like, different, I'm guessing it's different animations for the crosses and stuff like that. Clinical finishing. Strike the ball right and finish like a pro. Better placement of the foot and ankle gives players variety in shooting and goals scored. You'll be able to feel where the ball is struck and adjust your approach for improved accuracy and power. So yeah, I think this is great. Another addition is to compete at a higher level. FIFA Trainer. Reach your potential with FIFA Trainer. Learn as you play with an optional graphic overlay that prompts you with gameplay options depending on your position on the pitch and training level. Basic commands get you started, while deep hints will improve the game of the most skilled players. I think you do have the option to actually, like, turn this off when you're playing, because it'll be a bit, like, boring if you just see it on it every time and you don't need them, such as me. And I've played FIFA since FIFA 2005, which was a World Cup game. No, it's FIFA 2005, and then I got the World Cup game as well. But I have played games such as FIFA 98. So, yeah. And then this is what I've been wanting in the game for years. Women. Now, this isn't because all that stuff. But what I'm thinking is women will be a great addition. They've started with only 12 national teams. So women are in the game. Compete as 12 women's national teams for the first time in the FIFA franchise and kick off an offline tournament and online friendly matches. But it's just great because it'll bring more people for EA. Women's football is getting much bigger. I watched the FA Cup final the other day of Chelsea versus Notts County. That was massive. I really enjoyed watching it. It was so exciting, and I just thought the women were so good in that game. They're incredible, and to think that some people didn't even know that women had professional football teams. It's just mad, because it's just great what women can do. People don't expect women to be that good at football, but they are. They're like the people in the World Cup. They're amazing. Well done to USA. But the English team did amazing as well. And we lost to an unlucky own goal. No one's fault. It's just luck, isn't it? Yeah, that's it for now. The next video I do will either be on Ultimate Team, Career Mode, or stadiums and other stuff you need to know. So yeah, if you have enjoyed, leave a like on the video, as it is always appreciated. Subscribe if you're new, and I will see you guys next time for the next video.